Hey, horse people. Okay, so in this video, I thought the lady said our horse reared up and fell backwards for no reason. And I don't know, maybe I just added that, but evidently this title implies that this horse, remember our young filly, reared up and fell backwards. It kind of implies that when I was watching this, I was like, man, horses don't usually rear up for no reason. I wonder what caused this, because there's a cause when horses do behavior, especially odd behavior. So let's take a look. I mean, this is, well, first let me get to the rearing, and then so people won't cry and they can leave, and then I'll discuss what led up to it and my opinion on it. So here's where the horse rears up and falls over.
We're right here, so
my horse reared up and fell backwards.
We're right here, wow. Whoa, steady, steady. Whoa.
Whoa.
Whoa. What happened there?
Whoa, wow. Wonder what caused that. For no reason, a horse just reared up and flipped over all by itself. Stupid human had nothing to do with it, because she loves her horse. Now look, I don't want people going here and hating on this woman. I am generalizing on how people think when they deal with horses. So, look. She didn't do it on purpose, but that doesn't matter. Horses get killed and get labeled and taught bad lessons when the owner was not doing it on purpose, when they were trying to help the horse. They didn't know, Rick, you're being too hard on him. It wasn't their fault. It's always the human's fault, and it's never the horse's fault. So let's look at this video from the beginning on the things that irritate the hell out of me.
There he is. I wish I could bring Bella out, but I can't get her head collar on yet. So
Bella must be the one that flipped over. She said, I wish I could bring her out because I can't get a head collar on her. Head collar is a halter for, I don't know where she's at. It sounds like England, Britain, UK, somewhere. She's not from the US. It doesn't sound like, I mean, she could be here with an accent, but if she's saying terms like head collar and car park, we call it a parking lot. Over in the UK and Australia, I think they call it a car park. So anyway, so because of the terminology, I'm thinking she's not, but it doesn't matter where she's at, and it doesn't matter what her accent is, doesn't matter the color of the horse and all this other crap. This is about understanding horses. And the fact that she can't get a head collar or a halter on her horse automatically tells me, hey, you don't know what the hell you're doing, because that's not some big feat. That's not some scientific, you know, complex equation of trying to get a head collar on a horse. Granted, if a wild horse is a Mustang or a horse hasn't been handled right, it can be difficult, but it's not rocket science.
So that's just a work in progress. I'll be able to catch her either. So I'll have to wait a little bit until I get her to be a bit more confident with us.
Okay, so I see this guy petting the horse. And when I see a horse in a barn, locked up, dark, scary, the only time I see humans is when they want to put their hands on me or try and hurt me or try and do something or try and scare me. I automatically know, not smart, not good. I don't understand horses. I don't understand horse vision. I don't understand. It's a dark thing. Well, I put a light up there, Rick. Well, bright light. This light probably affects your horses. You know, people get headaches when they work around fluorescent lights all the time. Well, I don't leave it on all the time, Rick. I just turn it on when I go in there when it's dark. Well, when horses' eyes adjust to dark light because they have a lot of cones and rods that humans don't, it can take them 30 minutes to get their night vision. And if you ever wake up in the middle of the night, walk in, turn on the brightest light you got and look at it and watch the instant headache and how you'll close your eyes and it hurts and how it blinds you. That's what lights do to horses, and people just don't get it because they don't understand how horses see. But anyway, I digress. I'm going to go all over the place on this because there's so much in here. All right, so he's petting a horse, reaching, horse is turning his head, leave me alone. Ears really aren't back. He's just kind of like, all right, I'll let you pet me or you're going to feed me. I see a troubled, worried, look how slow he approaches. Look like a spider. I mean, move slow. Let me move slow because I don't want to make it nervous. The horse moves his head, looks away. I'll go for the ears and eyes, the most vulnerable area where a horse doesn't want to be touched by somebody he doesn't trust. This horse doesn't trust him. Why? Because he's sneaking up on him. Because he's treating the horse like he's a sneaky predator. And the horse is like, shit, what are you trying to do, man? Why are you trying to... Now, somebody, Rick, you don't know the history. This horse was abused. And they say, I don't care about all this. If you understand a horse, it doesn't matter what the horse's history is. Horses are prey animals. You need to talk to them in their language. So I'm watching this and I'm like, shit, these guys don't know what the hell they're doing.
This is the fourth time today I've been in, just looping the head.
Fourth time today. So the only time I come in here is to harass the horse because I can't control it. I don't know how to do it. I'm telling you, people, I know you're going to think I'm full of shit. I got to have a halter on this horse in under 30 minutes. Easy. Probably a lot quicker. But again, I know horses. I know pressure and release.
Lead rope over a neck.
But Rick, she has a cute horsey on her shirt. I know she loves it. She's a great person. She's wonderful. She rescued it. She saved it. I don't care about all that, people. I'm not hating on her. I'm hating on the ignorance in the horse world where people get up there and they see things like her posting a video, our young horse reared up and fell backwards. No, it didn't. You didn't know what you were doing and you caused the horse to rear up. You put pressure. You didn't let the horse turn. You didn't understand what you were doing and you caused the horse. Rick, she loves her horses. She would never hurt it. There's no way she caused it. You're freaking full of crap. She caused it. Let me ask you a question. Why didn't a horse rear up in here? Because she didn't do anything to make it rear up. The horse is in a small area. People that handle horses in small areas tell me they don't understand pressure and release. They're afraid of the horse. Somebody's going to say, well, Rick, she can't take it out. It's not a fro. She got it in there. How'd the horse get in there? Well, Rick, somebody else put it in there and it's been in there for 3 weeks. And she's really, the excuses are just never ending when it comes to horses. It's just crazy. And to me, it's all bullshit because I just look at it. I'm like, you don't know what you're doing. And I've watched people do this throughout the years at every barn, at every horse show, every horse person I know. I mean, granted, there's good horse people and there's people who understand a horse, but this dominates the horse world. This ignorance that you can't talk about a woman because 90% of the horses are owned by women. And since you can't talk about a woman, ignorance just grows and flourishes and continues and nobody wants to tell them they're wrong because they're sensitive, rigid, they're feeling, they're crying, you're mean, and you're just sexist. And there's 1,000 reasons on why you can't tell somebody they're wrong with a horse. So guess what? They never learn. They do the same thing that don't work, and they expect a different result. It's just crazy.
And I've started twitching her face in readiness for me to put the head collar on, but I can't put the...
Notice the stalking. Look, this woman's talking to the camera. Notice her walking back. Notice... She and this horse are exchanging body language. They're talking. People don't realize that. Oh, look, the horse is spooky, Rick. Look, she's being really good. She's being calm and she's not looking at the horse. And the horse doesn't know anything's up. The horse is just scared and spooky. The horse doesn't know that her actions is causing the horse to do this. No. The horse is just some stupid animal. He doesn't realize that she's stalking behavior, that she's trying to trap him.
The head collar on, without forcing her, I'm not going to force her. So I'm just going to build up confidence that she'll allow me to put hand over her head.
Build up confidence, horse's ears are back, horse's a she's lucky she didn't get kicked. See, this people will get in here and do this, and when the horse kicks them, they'll have the horse put to sleep because they'll call somebody, and because we can't blame you, I can't talk to you like you're an adult. I can't tell you, you're making a mistake. You're doing it wrong. You're causing this. You're screwing this horse up because you don't understand a horse. You can't say that, Rick. It's not fair. She's a woman. She's trying. She loves her horse. You're just being mean. You're sexist. You like to pick on women. I mean, it's just freaking, I get so tired of the excuses for ignorance in the horse world. But man, there's people out there that make a living on this. Oh, let me help you. You're doing so good. You're just buy my rope and buy my special carrot stick and buy my special videotape and I'll show you're so good and you're so great. That's how you get people to buy your shit. See, I ain't selling shit. I ain't selling nothing. And I ain't trying to get you to buy nothing. You can come and listen to me or you don't. Free country, free world. You can hit play, you can hit stop, you can leave, you can come back, you can refuse to come back. You can do whatever you want, okay? And if you want the information, great. And if you don't, well, that's okay. Like I said, don't go hate on this woman. I'm not necessarily targeting her. I'm saying what the norm is for females in horses nowadays. We've entitled them so much. We've made them so powerful and smart that we can't say anything bad about them unless you're mean and sexist and you're just picking on them. And so now the ignorance continues.
She's a good girl.
Sorry, my hair looks so...
She is so freaking lucky. If you need a small room like this, first of all, it's not smart to get in a small room like this because you don't have an escape. If you push this horse enough to where he goes in a fight and he turns and kicks you and you fall in a corner, this horse will instinctively, not because he's mean and trying to kill you, he will back his butt in and kick you. Because in his mind, I'm telling you to get away. And because you're so stupid, you got in this trapped room, you don't get away. You're telling me that you don't have to listen to me. And I'm telling you that you do. See, if a horse kicks you in an open pasture, you can roll, run, get away. Or he can run and get away. And then he's not forced into this fight and dominance fight to where he has to dominate you and he can't back down. Otherwise, he'll appear weak. And he doesn't want to be weak because you're chasing him around, scaring him. You got him trapped. You got ears. You got bright lights on. You're blinding him. You're trying to sneak up on him. You're doing all these things to confuse him and put him into a fight or flight situation. And then when he goes there, you're like, damn, that horse was dangerous. That horse kicked my wife. The guy will be saying a horse kicked my wife. That horse cornered my horse. That horse cornered my wife in a little bitty room and kicked her and tried to kill her. That horse needs to be killed. I got to put him down. He's just too dangerous for anybody to handle because my wife knows what she's doing. And it wasn't her fault because she's my wife. I got to defend her. I got to protect her. I can't say anything bad. Hell, she won't cook me dinner. She won't give me sex. She won't, you know, she'll be mean. She'll treat me like crap. I gotta tell her she's right. I can't tell her she's wrong. She's a woman. You can't tell a woman she's wrong. If you do, you're a sexist. I mean, it's just crazy on how this shit, and because I'm willing to say it, I mean, there a lot of women, mostly women, subscribe to my channel. And most of them, when they do what I tell them and explain to them, not that I'm telling them to do it, I'm telling them how to do it. And they're smart enough to figure out that it works. And that I'm giving them good advice, so they follow it. Most of them come back and say, you changed my horse's life. My horse is better now. I'm better now. I understand how my horse thinks. We talk better. We don't fight. I don't do stupid things that cause my horse to fight. And then I don't blame my horse when I do stupid things. Those are smart women. Those are the women that get empowered. I'm freaking empowering smart women. Everyone else wants to empower ignorant women that want to be caught up and do. I'm a woman and you can't say that. You mean man, you. All right, whatever. See, that's why I always love horses. Because they don't care what bathroom they use and they don't care what your plumbing is. They treat everybody the same. Now, you'll hear people say, no, this horse doesn't like men. Or this horse doesn't like women. Or this horse doesn't like me because I make it listen. Or this horse doesn't like weak women. Or, you know, you can say all that. I'm telling you. Horses don't play that shit. You're either higher or lower. They trust you or they don't. You stalk and push them and trap them or you don't. You communicate so they understand what the right answer is or you confuse them and push and try to show them who's boss and do all the stupid shit and they end up fighting with you. And then you end up labeling the horse as stubborn, mean, not listening.
Such a mess. I haven't been to the hairdressers. There's no hairdressers open yet. And I had my hat on. And yes.
What is this horse doing walking in a circle? If you understand horses, he's trying to get release from pressure. Now, all horses will try to get release from pressure. But when you do this in an enclosed area, you risk the horse saying, if I can't get away, if backing away isn't the right answer, I've got to look for another answer to get this person off me. Let me try to kick or bite this person and see if that works. And guess what? Most of the time it works with humans. Especially humans that don't know what they're doing, because then they get scared. And then they back away. And then the horse learns, oh, I get it. The right answer to get this human from putting pressure is to bite or kick them. Because when I tried to back away, it didn't work.
Bad hair day. Sorry. Renz is the same, and he calls it coop COVID.
She's just frightened. She's not striking out or trying to kick or anything. She's just frightened.
She's not striking out or trying to kick. Really? Well, what causes a horse to do that? Who knows the answer to that? Too much pressure. Trapping a horse. Making a horse feel that there's no right answer except striking out or kicking. No, Rick, I've seen horses, they just kick. They've been taught by other idiots that that's the right answer. They just don't do it naturally. You don't see horses out in a herd just running around kicking and fighting with everybody. Doesn't happen. They learn their place. They don't mess with the higher horse. They respect the higher horse. They listen to the higher horse. And they go about eating and being a horse. You don't see the things that humans create when there's no humans around.
I'm actually just like a wild horse. We don't have wild horses here in the UK, apart from, you know, like on forest ponies, that sort of thing. But she's like, I see on the westerns, where they bring all the Mustangs in. She's like that. She just totally doesn't understand.
Another thing this woman is doing, when you're working with a horse like this, the worst thing you can do is not give it your full attention. The worst thing you can do is talk. When you're talking, the horse is kind of like, what is she saying? Imagine if you went up to a horse and tried to work with it and it was, and was just loud and vocal and wouldn't shut up. Would you think something was odd? Would you think that, damn, there's something wrong with this horse? Because horses don't normally do that. Horses talk with body language, not with their mouth. Human, especially some humans, depending on what bathroom they use, talk more than other humans. Rick, you can't say that. You're... Oh, shut up, you big crybabies.
Humans. They don't understand humans. No funny things, aren't they? Good girl. I know you're back.
Horse is trapped. He's flinching. And he's in a corner. Now, if this happened in an open area, I wouldn't be so kind of against it. And there's going to be people here that, Rick, it worked. She did good. Why are you cracking on her? Just because something works does not mean it's good. She's not communicating. She's not, when you do things and you put it in a vacuum, remember, training a horse is a process. It's not an event. That's why all these clinicians, they get you to buy these freaking videos and they make it an event. Here, buy this video on trailer load. Here, buy this video on leading. Here, buy this video on haltering a horse. Here, buy this video on picking a horse's feet up. Here, buy this video on how to get your horse over a scary object. Here, buy this video. When they isolate things and make people think that horse training is an event and not a process, they rip you off. Because everything you do to a horse teaches a horse later for prior learning. What this horse is learning long term, even though she's accomplishing what she wants and she thinks the lesson was good. Remember, she's been in there 4 times today and she's still doing this. 4 times and she's still doing this. Even though she's successful, what did the horse learn? Not what did she learn, not what did she tell you, because she'll tell you the horse learned. See, the horse allowed me to put the rope on. No, the horse didn't allow you. The horse learned to back away, to try to release pressure. I can't. When I'm trapped, this human's going to do this. I'll go into a freeze. Remember, fight or flight. There's the third part of freeze. Fight, flight, or freeze. When a horse freezes, that means they're confused. They don't know what the answer is. They're looking for the answer. They're getting pressure, but they're afraid to make a choice on what's the right answer because they haven't been taught what the right answer is. So they freeze. When a deer runs out on a highway at night and the headlights hit him in the eyes and it blinds him, he freezes. People say, stupid deer, ran right out from our car and just stood there. Stupid deer. No, he went into fight, flight, or freeze and he froze because he can't see. And when a prey animal can't see and they're afraid to run into danger or run out of danger, but they don't know where the right path is to run, they freeze. Well, they're still in a fight or flight response, which you don't want horses in, and they're still in a situation to where they can blow up, like the horse did when it reared. But anyway.
Boxed yourself into a bit of a corner, haven't you? That's it. You can get away, but I'm not moving. It's funny that she backs up rather than runs forward.
It's funny, she backs around her stall. What the hell else is she going to do? See, when I see a horse backing around, it's scared. It's trying to relieve pressure. It's confused. This horse hasn't learned to give pressure so it can move its feet. When you round pin a horse, you put pressure, but you allow the horse to get released by running. And when the horse gets tired of running, it will look for a different answer. And when it looks to you, if you know what you're doing, you will immediately stop pressure and back away. And the horse learns, shit, when I look at this person, he stops making me run. Perfect. That's what I want you to do. Baby steps. We have to build a foundation. Looking at me will never give you pressure. Now, idiots, when they look at him, the horse must want to change position. Let me make it run the other way. Then the horse learns, shit, even when I look at him, I got to run. So looking at him must not be the right answer. This horse, what is he learning the right answer? Backing, freezing, ears back, nervous, frustrated, fearful.
I've never dealt with a wild horse, so this is my first wild horse.
Wild horse. This is a wild horse? Let me tell you something. If you think this is a wild horse, you ain't never worked with a wild horse. I got news for you. This ain't no freaking wild horse. This horse is very, very docile and accepting a lot of BS that a lot of horses would not accept.
This is a good girl. Good girl.
Oh, yeah. Good girl. I'm going to get to this good girl crap in a minute.
Back round her now. She noticed I could actually put my hand under her neck, whereas I couldn't this morning. Good girl. So what I want to under her neck. Good girl. This wild horse. This is a good girl. Good girl.
So, the video cut here. When she turned to grab in here. So I don't know what happened. But she reached and faced the horse. Remember when you face a horse, you create more pressure if you know what you're doing. Now she reached around the horse. So I have my hand on his neck, on this side, and underneath his neck. What is the horse thinking? You're trying to grab me by the neck. You're trying to encircle me. You're trying to trap me. A better way would have let this rope hang and used the hand instead of on top to scratch the horse's belly and not face the horse and reach under. That would have put less pressure. That's why I'm saying this. She doesn't understand what pressure. She's putting more pressure when the horse is already frozen. This would be the time to give the horse less pressure because he's not moving. And not moving is a better answer than moving. So why do you want to put more pressure? She did it because she doesn't understand. She doesn't realize that putting a hand underneath and on top and facing and reaching forward is all pressure, 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 pressure. She's lucky the horse didn't blow up in here.
Yeah, so she let me put that round her now.
But Rick, she said good girl and it worked. Why are you saying she did it wrong? She did do it wrong. I can do a lot of things wrong and it works. I mean, I can use a hammer when I should use a screwdriver. I can get the screw in and say, look, it worked. I used a hammer. Well, yeah, but it's freaking dumb and it's stupid and it's not going to last long term and it's not the way it was designed to work.
She noticed I could actually put my hand under her neck, whereas I couldn't this morning. Good girl. So what I want to do is just practice having that round her. I'm not even putting it over her nose now.
Now see, she's moving slow and thinking that's good. I'm saying that's bad. The horse is still reactive. She's making this a big deal. Guess what? The horse is now seeing it as a big deal. This should be routine, normal, throwing a rope over him. He should be normal. I mean, this is a bad situation, dark, four corners, not round, in a room, no escape. But Rick, it worked. She didn't get hurt. She's wonderful. She's the greatest trainer ever. You couldn't do it. Okay, whatever. Then go, you know, get your training from her. Like I said, this isn't personal to her. This is all horses, all horse behavior, and anybody that handles things like this.
I just want to get her used to me touching up near her ear. Good girl, aren't you?
So this horse is very reactive. Watch the jerkiness When she moves the rope, watch her when she grabs the rope. Watch her horse jerk.
So what I want to do is just practice.
Boom. Head went up. See that? Very slight. A horseman would see that. She didn't see it. She's looking at the freaking rope and she's talking. She didn't notice that. So these are the little things when it tells me the horse, this horse isn't comfortable. He's not learning. He's still fearful. He's still reacting. He's not responding. He's very reactive. Why? Because he hasn't been taught pressure and release. He doesn't trust her. She's not doing things consistent like another horse. She's acting like a predator who thinks she's smart and moving in a way that makes the horse uncomfortable. She doesn't know that. She's looking at the rope. Rick, she didn't, that horse didn't react. You're just making it up. Watch the horse head. So you can figure out a reaction.
Just practice.
Boom.
Having that rounder. I'm not even putting it on her nose now. I just want to get her used to me touching up near her ear.
She just did it again. A horse moved again.
Yeah, aren't you?
Horse did it again. Ears went back. Head went away. What does she do? She moves to the head. She puts pressure and forces the head in. Now, I'm not trying to say this woman doesn't do anything right. She's horrible. Look, she's not being over-aggressive. She's not beating the horse in a submissive. Of course, there's worse ways to do this. You can always say that, and that's how people will defend bad technique. Well, it's a worse way, and maybe she didn't want to be mean. And man, you're just picking on her. And, people, look. If you want to my opinion and my observations to really understand a horse, I'll give it to you. But if you want to come here and argue about I'm picking on her because she's a woman and this is a sex thing, then just leave. Just don't watch me. Because, I mean, that's not my point. My point is to help horses, and I help a lot of horses. And I get people to understand horses that want to listen. But if you're so caught up into what bathroom you use that you can't freaking hear anything else, then you're on the wrong freaking channel. Please. Unsubscribe, leave, whatever. I'm not doing this so you like buy my stuff and give me money. I'm doing this to help horses and to help people who want help.
Girl, just move this way so the camera can see. Good girl. Yes, that's a good girl. Good girl, yes, and I can touch your face.
Good girl, yeah, you've got your ears pinned back. You're telling me you don't want me around. I'm crowding you. You're trapped. Good girl. Good girl! Does anybody see the difference in what she sees and what the horse sees? This is my biggest thing when I work with people. What is the horse learning? What are you teaching the horse? Do you think this horse gives a shit whether she says, good girl, or you're a killer horse and I'm going to eat you for dinner? Do you think that horse gives a shit? But she says, good girl. Now, look, I tell my guys, good boy, all the time. And I talk to them, and I kind of do it sometimes to exaggerate, to be stupid. But I know my horse is ignored, and I know it doesn't mean shit. What means something is how my horse reacts. What result do I get? This horse should tell her what result she's getting. But Rick, it's not rearing. Yeah, it's not rearing now. It rears in a couple minutes and falls over and could have broke its neck. And it was her fault. And nobody's going to want to blame her because they don't want to be mean, because they don't want to make her feel bad, because Rick, she's trying and she loves it. And it's a wild horse and the excuses will fly.
It's there now. She wouldn't let me do that this morning. So as I say, this is the fourth time I've come in to do this.
Fourth time.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl. Your ears are back. Good girl. Notice when she stopped, the horse almost looked at her and then she looked back. If she would have released pressure, the horse would have felt better and would have maybe learned positive, but she didn't. She put more pressure and the horse went back. Very slight. Watch this.
Good
Watch
girl.
The horse's head.
Good
when
girl.
She stops and releases, the horse is like, cool, I can relax my ears. I'll drop my head. Then she looks at it. Ears went back. Now she reaches. Pressure. No concept of pressure and release. No concept of release is reward. The horse learns when you stop doing it and you get a good response. She totally blew it.
Stop. Good girl. Good girl.
Stops. Watch the horse reaction. Head drops. Horse gets relaxed. Horse's ears start to go forward and goes, woo, man, finally got this woman to leave me alone. Give me some release. Woo, I can relax. He gets 1 second of relaxation. And she goes back in with pressure. She doesn't understand that she undid and she did not teach anything good to the horse at this moment. She missed it because she's not a horse person, because she doesn't understand a horse. But Rick, she's trying, and it's a wild horse, and you're just picking on her. Shut up, you freaking crybabies, and listen.
Now stop. It's a good girl.
And we got to go right back. Force the horse's head into the wall. Ears go back. I put pressure. I reach and grab like predators do. I look like predators do. And I don't understand why this horse, I'm in here four times in a day and I still haven't been able to get a freaking halter on it. I don't understand it. Well, Rick, it's just a wild horse. Yeah, okay, that's it.
Use the other hand as well, because that's a bit different. Different side of my body also affects the my fan. Good girl.
And I know somebody's going to send this video to this woman and say, this guy was mean and look, he used your video and he was just calling you names. Look, this woman can take this video just like everyone else, one of two ways. This guy makes sense. He's explaining the horse and he understands a horse. And maybe I don't know as much as I think I know. Maybe I could get better results if I knew more. Maybe I'm not perfect. Now, I know it's very hard for some women to admit that, but maybe she can take it as, I'm not perfect. Maybe he's right. If you look at the horse, how can you say that I don't know what I'm talking about? How can you say that I'm making stuff up on this horse? I'm just pulling it out of the wind. The horse is showing you and talking to you in body language with perfect communication, and unless I point it out, nobody's going to see it because they're more concentrating on her petting and saying, good boy, oh, it's fourth time, good boy, oh, you're a good boy.
Yeah, let me do there. Can I do there? Oh, good girl. Yes,
oh, yeah, good girl.
Rest it there.
Flitched your ears.
Yes.
I put you in the back. You've had to put your head. I've got you to where you can't face. You can't get any further away from me. You're a good girl. There's no way for you to avoid me. I have you trapped. You're a good girl. Does anybody see what I'm saying? I mean, I try to make it clear, but a lot of people just don't get it. They're so emotional, like, oh, you're just being mean and made it up here. You hurt my feelings. I'm going to go cry and get my big coconut scone, and I'm going to eat some pink popcorn to make me feel better because you're a big meanie. All right, whatever.
Good girl.
Turn your head away. So what's her answer? Again, doesn't understand pressure and release. This horse has no way said, I'm accepting this. And you're teaching me a good thing. And what does she do? She moves in. Watch her feet. I'm going to go back. Watch this.
Let's get there.
Horse head in the wall.
Yes,
can't get further away. Leave me alone. Quit. I'll move in closer. That's what I'll do. That's a great idea. Because when a horse tells you that you're putting too much pressure and I'm trying to get release, the right answer is to move in closer and keep talking and keep petting. Anybody that understands a horse knows exactly what I just said and knows it's 100% correct. This is why people don't get results. This is why it takes four times. This is why the horse flips over when it gets outside.
Okay. I've speeded up here and I've cut some pieces out because it's all repetition and I don't want to bore you to death.
Video was cut again. You see that reaction? Watch the horse react, jerked, because why? Why did the horse jerk, Rick? Well, it's just nervous, Rick, because it's a wild horse and it doesn't like you touching its face. No, it's trapped. It's been telling her with its ears and body, leave me alone, you're putting too much pressure, I need release, you're trapping me, help me. Help me understand what is the right answer, what do I need to do to get you to stop? That's what the horse has been saying the whole time. And what's she been saying? Nothing you do can get me to stop. I'm going to do what I want to do because I'm the smart human. I'm in charge. I'm the boss and you got no choice and you better listen and watch the horse flinch and then the video gets cut. Why? Flinch. Now the video's cut. What happened? See, I'm always skeptical when I see things like this cut out because people are trying to push their agenda or whatever.
Good. Just seems to be a face more than anything else. Obviously, I've not tried to touch her legs. But it does seem to be a face, but she doesn't seem to be bothered with this.
Actually, it flinched again. Actually, I think
face,
she would do better.
She shouldn't seem to be bothered with this.
Here, petting the horse in this area is less threatening. But you know what? She's more fearful of this area. Why? because she thinks the horse will kick her. She may be right. I mean, maybe she just has enough sense to stay away from the back of the horse. But if you work on this area and get the horse used to touching here, they're more willing to accept you when you get closer, because they'll say, when they touched me here, they didn't hurt me. But when you go straight to the head, where predators go, where things that want to kill it goes, when you stare and you put pressure and you trap and you get your arms and body and head and everything around the horse's head, the horse has never learned that it didn't hurt me here. Maybe it won't hurt me here. Survival instincts tell, don't let things around your head. Don't let predators around your face. If they take away your eyes, if they trap you and you can't run away, that's your survival skill. But you have to understand a horse to understand what you're doing.
So that'll do it for
now. Another jerky cut.
Good girl,
cut
out. Like patting. Because Steve went like that, and she really got quite upset with that little movement. As you can see, she doesn't like it.
The horse has been backing away this entire time. What is the horse learning the right answer is? Back away. But Rick, what is she? Look, I can't explain, you know, how to build a house in a 20, 30, 40 minute video. Okay? There's a lot of things to building a house. Foundation, concrete, was it laid right? How long it set? You know, rebar, was it leveled before? What kind of footings underneath the concrete? Then you got framing, nails, what kind of wood? Then you got bathroom, plumbing, then you got electrical. There's a lot of shit to building a house, okay? And people want to come here and go, I want to know how to train a horse. Okay, here, watch this 20-minute video, and I'll tell you how to train a horse. And that's how they think training a horse is. Training a horse is like building a house. You start with foundation and you have to make, there's a lot of moving parts. There's a lot of different things that interact. Everything works together. And if you don't know what you're doing, you're going to screw it up.
She's going to have to get used to that sort of tapping, because otherwise.
Head bobbing. Head's going up. You're putting too much pressure. Why are you touching me? Why are you facing me? Why are you by my head? Why do you, what do I need to do? I'm talking like a horse. Okay. This is the horse talking. What do I need to do to get you to stop putting pressure on me? What is the right answer? I've backed away. I've pinned my ears. I've moved my head. I've jerked. I've showed you that you scared me. What is the right answer to get you to stop doing this pressure? Because she doesn't know that the horse is saying this. She doesn't know how to tell the horse what she wants to do. She doesn't know what the right answer is. In her mind, and everyone else that's watching and think I'm just picking on her, they think the right answer is, she got the rope around her neck. It's a success. It's perfect. No. The horse is learning, you don't know what you're doing. I can't talk to you. You don't listen to me. When I tell you I'm scared, you ignore me. When I tell you I'm fearful and I'm trying to create distance and I need release, you don't listen to me. We don't talk. I just get scared and you put pressure on me. That's what the horse is learning. Rick, you're just picking on her. It's not, all right, whatever.
She's going to be too reactive to put a saddle on or anything like that. You don't need to back up. You're a good girl. So it's just, when she backs up, I just go with her. I don't try and hold her back. I couldn't hold her back. So it's no point trying. So we just go with, don't we? Hey, good girl. Good girl.
Horse is trapped. Not only is it trapped, it's backed into whoever filming. So it's getting pressure from who's ever filming and another human predator. So now the horse is in a small square room with no release. He's been getting pressure the whole time. It's done everything in this world to release pressure and it's backed in. And now there's another human behind it. So it's trying to keep it in this eye here. Remember, when a horse uses one eye, it's called monocular. Mono, one, it's using one eye. When a horse uses one eye, it can't focus. That's only to see predators and shades and shapes. The only time a horse can focus is when you're in front and it sees you with two eyes, which is why horse trainers a lot will say, I want two eyes. I want the horse to be able to focus and see what I'm doing. This woman is not using any of those things or any of that knowledge to her advantage. She's got the horse backed into one predator filming. Horse is seeing in his peripheral on the side. It's not clear. It's been scared. Its ears are back. It's backed away. It's in a corner again. But Rick, why did the horse flip over? Why does this have anything to do with the horse flipping over? Because she doesn't understand pressure and release. She hasn't communicated with the horse and taught it good things. She's taught it that the only way I get release is to run and be fearful.
You're all right.
You're all right. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, the horse knows that. When you say you're all right to a horse, because horses speak English, they understand that you told them they have nothing to be fearful about. Anybody believe that? Well, you're a freaking idiot.
You're all right. Yeah. Good girl.
Horse's head's going up. We call that a clue. She's probably like, oh, look, it's paying attention to me. The horse is almost bowing up like, why are you trying to get over my head now? I'm surprised the horse didn't rear here. I'm surprised the horse didn't bite here. I'm surprised it didn't kick at the camera and bite and strike because it had so much pressure. She does not think this is a bad thing at all. She thinks this is normal. Poor horse.
Good girl. There you go.
Again, another what I call a hard cut. Or what happened here? Why is the video cut? Or just cut. What happened? What happened in a cut? Videos with lots of cuts tells me that we're showing our supposed successes and we're cutting out problems, failures.
I'm just going to pull it around gentle like that. It's a good girl. And it's just going to drop onto the floor, so I'll just stand back a little bit. Good girl.
Had she done what she just did here at the end of the rope, it would have been much better. She kept pressure. She did not relieve pressure. She thinks by taking the rope off, she did the horse a favor. But she stayed here and the horse is still trapped. Had she walked to the end of that rope, released pressure on the horse, he probably would have looked at her and would not have reacted at all to this rope, because he wouldn't have felt threatened and trapped and close and enclosed and trapped and reaching and grabbing and pressure. He wouldn't have felt any of that. But she did it right here. Why? Because she doesn't understand about pressure and release. She doesn't understand what this horse is saying to her. She doesn't know how to talk to the horse to get the right result. She doesn't know how to give the horse release when she gets the right answer. I'm not even sure what the right answer is. Who knows what the right answer is here? Some of you, I guarantee you're thinking, well, the right answer is the horse doesn't rear or kick or bite her. That's the right answer. That's not the right phrase. You don't want to teach a horse where they have to try and figure out that that's not the right answer, because that's not what they're learning. It's what you wish they were learning.
Well done. Good girl.
Well done, good girl. What exactly did she do that was well done and good? She pinned her ears. She backed away. She was trapped in a corner. She's scared of you. What was the well done part? Well, Rick, she was able to pet it, and she got the rope around, and she got the rope off, and the horse didn't flip over and kill itself, so it's a success. Really? That's a success? That's not a success in my book. Okay, so clue number two. When we have people with cute buckets and food, and we try to feed horses and think that somehow the horse is going to see us as their friend and their food provider, and we're buddies, and look at me, you can trust me because I feed you. Horses don't want to be fed. Horses don't want that the only way I get food is if I put up with your BS. Because sooner or later they'll figure out, you know what? I'm tired of putting up your BS. I think I'll just take the food. And then what are you going to do? I mean, she's already admitted that if the horse wanted to pull away, it could. So she does know that she can't outpower the horse. So she feeds it thinking that they're bonding. Who thinks that she's bonding with this horse by feeding it? I don't think that at all.
Good girl. I've mixed up a little bit of sugar beet for it.
Oh, sugar beets. Well, shit. If I give you a treat, then the horse will be able to connect that when I put a rope around your neck and scare you and make you back up and trap you, that you'll get beets afterwards. So that's a good lesson. Horses don't connect things like that, people. This horse is not connecting these beets has a good training lesson, has I let her put the rope around me, if I let her pet me, I'll get... That's not what the horse thinks. That's what humans think the horse thinks, but that's because they don't know how a horse thinks.
Because that won't do her any harm at all. She could do with some weight putting on.
I'm going to try and get the head collar on now.
Okay, I always love it when people go, try. When you're trying things with horses, you don't have a goal. You don't have a pass fail. You don't have a plan. You don't understand pressure and release. I don't try to get a halter on a horse. I go get a halter on a horse. I don't try to catch a horse in a 40-acre pasture and let the horse run away from me for 30 minutes and go, I tried. I'm trying. The horse is running, but I'm trying. Trying teaches bad lessons. Trying tells me you don't have a plan and you're hoping on luck. Luck is not a plan and luck is not a strategy, but there's a lot of luck in the horse.
I'm using, because I think it'll be easier to get that onto her, because I can just do that and pop it over a neck.
Okay, so she's using something because it'll be easier. What do I tell people about easy way with horses? The easy way is never the right way. The easy way is easy for the human. It's usually bad for the horse. If you have two choices, one way is harder and one way is easier, the harder way is normally the right way. It's easier to tie a horse to the rear of a Mack truck and drag him around with a halter and say, I'm teaching it to lead. That's easier. It's not good. It's not good for the horse. But Rick, it works. It does work. But it's not good. So don't take the freaking easy way. But she's using this halter because it's easy.
Neck. And then I'm going to try and put this up onto her nose and hold that at the same time. So we'll just try that, because I would like to get her into the paddock so she can get some good grass. But that might be a bit too soon. I mean, this is the fifth time I'm trying. So.
Fifth time I'm trying. Is this the fifth time that she's trying to get a rope around the neck, or is this the fifth time with the halter? Rick, why are you being so hard on her? I'm not being hard on her, people. I don't know this woman. She could be the nicest woman in the world. I'm not talking to her like this is all directed to her. I'm talking to people that will watch this and won't see what I see. I'm telling you what I see. This isn't personal.
So we'll just see.
I'm just going to try that again with the hand over. Good girl. Good girl. Yes, you are. Good girl. Now, are you going to let me just pop this onto your nose? Hey.
Ears. Looking away.
Good girl. Steady now. Steady.
Horse is trapped. Almost tried to run away. Now, let me say what she's doing right. She's at least not putting the horse into flight mode. I don't think she's doing it intentionally. I think she's lucky. But she's trying to be calm. She's not trying to get aggressive. And she's not trying to use bully. I'm going to show you who's boss and crap. Because that's worse in my opinion. But just because this is better than that doesn't mean it's good for the horse.
Steady, steady. Good.
Steady. Because the horse knows what steady means. Steady, good girl. Remember, the horse knows good girl, knows sugar beets, knows steady, knows it's okay, knows I love you. The horse knows all that because horses speak English, right? So I'll just talk to him in English.
Girl, clever girl. Just see if I can just tighten that up now. Get it right, don't let it slip off, do I?
And she ties the rope halter right. I got to point that out. Good for her.
I'm just tying it loosely.
And she tucks it in the throat latch so it's not flopping around. She does that good. Rick, why are you saying she's good now? You were saying, because you can do bad things and good things. And it still may not be good for the horse.
Just do that. I don't like the end flopping about. If they do start messing about, I don't want it to flap into the eye. So I always like to just tie those ends up.
I think she tied it right. Maybe she didn't. Let me blow this up. I don't know what the hell she did. Oh, she went and did a bunch of loops and loops and stuck. Okay, so I don't agree with that. Just hang it on a throat latch and let it go back. The knot is tied correctly, though.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl. Oh, sorry. That was a bit of a rattle on the old chain, wasn't it? Because this is quite a heavy link. Good girl.
Buckle. Big metal buckle. She said it was a heavy link. It's a big metal buckle that when this horse gets in a panic, it's going to hurt it. And it's going to hit it. And it's going to mess up training. I don't like metal. I don't like buckles for that very reason.
I'm going to need my gloves. That's it in there. Take it away. We don't want
to. Okay. Here's another clue. We don't know what we're doing. I mean, the only thing worse is this bucket was pink. But I think she's got pink on her gloves, so that probably helps. So we got another guy in here who probably admits that he doesn't know about horses, and he looks to her as the expert. But he's here with the bucket of food. Anytime I see horse training and a bucket of food, that's a clue that the people don't know what the hell they're doing. I'm sorry. You can hate on me. You can say it works. You can say it's really good and I use it, and knock yourself out. I'm telling you, if you're using a bucket, you are not understanding a horse pressure and release. You're trying to bribe and trick. And when you bribe and trick horses, horses learn bad lessons and they get tired of getting tricked, or they figure out the trick, or they get tired of getting bribed. And then you see the real horse, and then you're running around the hospital saying, I don't know what happened. The horse was doing so good. I was feeding it, and all of a sudden it just reared up and flipped over, and it got up and kicked me, and I tried to save it, and I just don't know what happened. It was crazy. We were doing so good. That's what I'll hear when it goes bad.
Happening until we get there. Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Come on.
Come on.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Just be careful you don't get right in front of me in case you shoot.
So we have two people blocking the path, putting pressure that they don't understand. She should be at the very end of this rope. This guy should be totally out of the way so the horse has plenty of room to walk out freely. What do? We crowd the horse. We look at the horse. We stare at the horse. We put pressure. We crowd the horse like the idiots who's trying to force a horse in a horse trailer do. And they're actually pressuring the horse into the stall. They're not giving the horse plenty of room to walk out of the stall. They're pressuring the horse into the stall. But Rick, they're trying. Okay. But Rick, they're feeding it. Okay. But Rick, she's got gloves and she's trying. All right. Whatever.
Forward, because we don't want to knock you over. Come on now. Good girl. Come on.
Good girl.
No, you can't have any until you come out.
Come
you need to
then.
Come out first.
Come on then.
Good girl. I'll put this bucket in front so the horse has to walk over it and put more pressure. Rick, why are you picking on the man? I'm not picking on anybody, people. I'm just telling you, when I see these videos, it just drives me nuts at the multitude of errors and the lack of pressure and release and giving a horse a open space and allowing the horse to come out freely without pressure. And instead, I see this and it's like, gee, I wonder why you're not getting results.
Come on then. Good girl.
Good girl. Good girl. What exactly is this horse doing that's good? Well, Rick, she's not rearing up and flipping over. Oh, okay. That's how a horse gets good girl. Okay, I got it.
Good girl.
Good girl.
That little bit. But she knows that it is the nice stuff. Come on, then. Come on now. Walk on. Walk on.
So she doesn't give release. She's putting pressure. The horse doesn't want to get close to her and run her over. It already feels trapped. You got a predator here and a predator here. And what's the answer? I'll pull. I'll pull and say, good girl. Again, doesn't understand pressure and release. Doesn't understand that if she walked to the end of this rope, this horse would have walked out very nicely. If this guy wasn't here and she was at the end of the rope, the horse's own curiosity would have drove it to walk out here and check out the area. Instead, we got to make it. We're the humans. We're smart. We have to force it. We have to show it because the stupid horse doesn't know. We have to be the smart human and show it with food and trick it and pull on it and get in his face and tell it it's a good girl.
Welcome. Good girl.
Good girl. Good girl.
Good girl.
Good night. Sorry.
So I reach and I put pressure and I force the horse back into there. Quick, somebody tell me, if you're a horse, what's the right answer? Every time you work with a horse, you ought to be thinking, what is the horse learning? What am I telling the horse the right answer? Because whenever I stop putting pressure, I'm telling the horse, that's what you need to do to get me to stop. So what's the right answer here?
Good girl.
Good step. Girl.
When the human walks
good
up,
girl.
I back away.
It's gonna be night.
When they reach, I back away.
It's going to be nighttime, isn't it, before we get there?
And then what? Then I get food. What's the right answer? Not what you think the right answer. What did the horse figure out the right answer was? In order to get release of pressure, I back up. When I back up, I get food. Wow, this horse is going to be the smartest horse in the world. It's learning all these great lessons.
Come on then. Come on then.
Come on, walking on.
If this guy wasn't blocking a horse's path, it would probably walk out. But Ricky's trying to help, and he's trying to give him food. You're just picking on him because you don't like him because he's whatever. This isn't about, it's about the horse. What is the horse learning?
Come on then.
Ah, she finally gave the horse a little bit of release. She moved to the end of the rope. I didn't watch all this before, so I'm kind of just watching it now. She finally gives the horse release. What does her helper do? He puts pressure. He gets in front of the horse with a bucket. He's putting pressure. He's blocking the path for the horse to come out, and he thinks he's trying to help. Look at me. I got food. I'll help. Never get help when you're training a horse. That's another clue that people don't know what they're doing. It confuses the horse. It's getting multiple directions. It's worried about multiple people. The people cannot communicate on what the other one is thinking or what they're about to do or what they're going to do. So you aren't working together. It's very, very bad to use multiple people to train a horse. Stay the hell out of it. Stay away. Don't create pressure. Watch from a distance. Rick, why are you picking on him? He's just a man and he's trying to, and he's got his orange bucket. He's trying to, whatever.
Come on. Come on. Good girl.
Yeah, walk right, nice. Walk on, right over past the other human. Step on him. Run him out of the way.
If you just go back a couple of yards, maybe she'll come.
We have three people. I forgot. There's a guy putting pressure with the camera.
Okay, back you go then. Back up now. Back. Good girl.
Good girl.
Walk on. Walk on. Walk on.
It's starting to come.
Girl.
Walk on.
She's got a pull. She's got a pull.
Good girl. Good girl. Come on, look.
Good girl.
See ya.
I backed up. Good girl.
You can do it. Good in your girl. Own time. We can wait for you.
Who thinks this horse learned good lessons here?
Good girl. Good girl, yes.
It came out, her immediate response. She wanted the horse to come out. And when it comes out, she stands there. Are you freaking kidding me? This just drives me nuts. I look at this poor horse trying to find the right answer. When it finally does what we want the right answer to be, she blocks its path. You've been trying for 20 minutes to get this damn horse out of the stall. And when it comes out, you stand in front and block its path. Are you freaking kidding me?
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Perfect opportunity for her to, if she understood pressure and release, release pressure and move away.
Yes, good girl. Yes, this is all very, very exciting, isn't it? Oh, yes. Flip it into there for you. Good girl.
Soon as the horse starts to eat, what happens? Another predator comes in and puts pressure. No understanding of pressure and release. No understanding that when a horse is doing what we want, we need to leave it alone. What is the horse supposed to do to get left alone? Nothing. The answer is fucking nothing. This horse does not have anything it can do to stop people from messing with it. It's just doing things at random, figuring out that nothing I do works. There's no consistency. I don't know what the right answer is because I've tried 30 different things and sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't.
Okay. Try walking on a bit. Good girl. Oh, that's good. Good girl. Oh, yes. Gravel. Yes. Baru thinks exactly the same and Ike doesn't like it either. Ike hates going on the...
Dangerous situation. She should be creating distance and giving the horse plenty of leeway to move and feel comfortable. Instead, she stays next to the horse. This is how you get a horse to jump on you. This is how you get a horse to spook. When this horse flips over, remember when it flipped over? If he did that here, it would be on a concrete, or he would have to run over her and knock her into the wall and knock her out, and then to be saying the horse is wild. And it knocked my wife or this woman down and tried to kill her. And, you know, it's just, this poor horse doesn't have a chance.
Yeah. But we'll try it, shall we? Can we try it?
Oh, there's a nice purple bucket to match the orange bucket. Purple. Wow. A little pink on the gloves. Woo. I should have known this was going to be a success.
Yes, good girl. Oh,
good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl. Now we got two people saying good girl. Good girl. Everybody's talking. Everybody's talking. The horse has been talking since this thing started. Ain't nobody heard a damn word the horse said. They're just too busy saying good girl.
Good girl.
Hey, girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Whatever size you like me, I'll just find me. Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl. Come on then, little bit of dinner here.
The horse was out there and wanted to eat. Instead of giving it a break and letting it eat and relax for a second, no. Good girl, I'm going to yank on you. Watch this horse. Horse is nervous. Horse is looking around. He gets the grass and wants to eat and smell the ground. She pulls on a rope and says, good girl, and says, no, I want you to keep walking. What is the horse learning? It's learning that no matter what I do, this human is going to keep putting pressure on me. At some point, I got to try to get away. I got to see if I can overpower and get away. Ready for the ring?
Oh, no, she's going. She's going. That's another thing. Good.
Walking, open. I got to go get the food. More pressure. More guy. Let me help. I got food. Let me get help. Food. The horse already tried to eat grass, and you told it no. It was a good girl. Now we're going to try to shove food in his face.
Good girl. Good girl. Come on,
good
then.
Good girl, Bella.
Good girl.
Good girl, Bella.
Come on,
Bella. Come.
Horse is scared, nervous, head high, staring, pressure, new area, hasn't been allowed to eat grass, been pressured, all the wrong lessons to get out of this freaking stall.
Come on, I think I'm going to leave the head collar on.
Yeah.
Come on.
Pull. Horse's head's high. That's a clue. When a horse's head is high, it's nervous. It's about to react. It's fearful. It's going to go into fight or flight. You better pay freaking attention. No, Rick. She knows what she's doing. She'll just pull on it.
We're right here, so if there's any problem. We're right here, so if there's...
Horse finally said, I got to get away from this. I'm done. What does she do? Hangs onto the rope. Had she let the rope loose, she wouldn't have ripped the horse's head backwards, and he wouldn't have reared. He would have turned and tried to move away. She could have went with it with the rope, and instead, she holds the rope. She tries to overpower it. She has his head. You can overpower the head. Where you pull the head, the body will follow. She pulls this horse over. Had this horse would have been able to turn, he would not have reared and flipped over. She yanked on the rope.
Ooh, steady.
When it went up, she pulled on the rope. Whoa, steady. Good girl. Whoa, steady. Good girl. She pulls and puts her weight, squatting down, gripping the rope, and yanks the horse over.
Steady.
Horse falls. Bad lesson.
Whoa.
Wow. Who could have predicted that? Boy, that was really... This horse is wild.
Whoa. What happened there?
Whoa. What happened? I've been telling you what's happening since you started in the stall. I've been telling you didn't teach his horse pressure and release. It didn't understand what the right answer. You've been putting nothing but pressure and pressure. And because you had it in a small, confined area, you thought you were being successful. You thought the horse was under control. And when it got out in an area where it could fly and run, you yanked it over on his head. And now you're like, whoa, wow. How did that happen? Woo. Man, that was scary. Lucky the horse isn't dead. Lucky. Lucky isn't a strategy. It's not a plan. But sometime it works. This horse is lucky. This woman is lucky. But you know what? Somehow people will come here and blame me for picking on the poor woman who's trying her best. All right, you can take what you want from it. This horse is easy and has a lot of patience. And this could have been done a lot easier. And this horse did not have to learn this lesson. But it did. And this can be good or bad. Does a stupid human learn from this and change what they're doing? Or do they think it's a horse problem and the horse is crazy and they do the same thing? My guess is they're going to do the same thing. Well, Lynette there, don't go to her channel and give her hate. I'm going to try and blur out the damn channel because I'm not doing this to get them hate. I'm doing it to teach people on all the wrong lessons. All right, well, Lynette there. Buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.